एवरीवन, वेलकम टू लर्निंग विद डॉक्टर शिवांगी। टुडेज टॉपिक इज सिक्वेंशियल सैम्पलिंग। सो इन टुडेज टॉपिक वी विल नो अबाउट द व्हाट इज मीनिंग ऑफ सिक्वेंशियल सैम्पलिंग। एज इन द प्रीवियस वीडियोज वी विल ऑलरेडी डिस्कस अबाउट द प्रोबेबिलिटी सैम्पलिंग एंड नॉन प्रोबेबिलिटी सैम्पलिंग एंड टाइप्स ऑफ प्रोबेबिलिटी सैम्पलिंग एंड नॉन प्रोबेबिलिटी सैम्पलिंग। सो वी डिस्कस इन दिस टॉपिक अबाउट दिस वीडियो। बिफोर आई स्टार्टिंग द टॉपिक आई वॉन्ट टू से यू दैट इफ यू लाइक माई वीडियो प्लीज़ लाइक एंड शेयर दिस वीडियो एंड सब्सक्राइब माई चैनल लर्निंग विद डॉक्टर शिवांगी। नाउ कमिंग टू द मेन टॉपिक विच इज सिक्वेंशियल सैम्पलिंग। So what is sequential sampling? Basically, it is a type of complex sample design. As we already discussed in the previous videos that there are three types of sampling, then probability or random sampling, non-probability or non-random sampling, and complex sampling. So what is complex sampling? Complex is mixture or combination of probability and non-probability sampling or random and non-random sampling. So sequential sampling is a type of complex sample design. So it includes few features of probability sampling and few features of non-probability sampling. So what is the meaning? In this type of sampling, basically the ultimate size of sample under technique is not fixed in advance, but is determined according to mathematical decision rules on the basis of information yielded as survey progresses. As in the probability sampling, for example, systematic sampling or random sampling, we take the criteria of probability or randomness to selecting the size of sample, whereas in the non-probability sampling, we can take our convenience or reliability to select the sample size. But in case of sequential sampling, the size of sample cannot be fixed in advance or not taken conveniently according to researcher, but it is determined according to mathematical decision rules on the basis of information collected, gathered as survey progresses. So it is based on collection of data basically. So it is the important point, what is that? The size of sample is based on collection of data. Basically, sequential sampling is usually adopted in case of acceptance sampling plan in context of statistical quality control. It is a very important point because this is not described or mentioned in all types of sampling. So it is basically used in SQC, statistical quality control. So it is very important type of sampling, also used in manufacturing units for quality control of products and services also. Now coming to the other features or types of sequential sampling. When a particular lot is to be accepted or rejected on the basis of a single sample, it is known as single sampling. When the decision is to be taken on the basis of two samples, then it is known as double sampling. And in the case the decision rests on the basis of more than two samples, but the number of samples is certain and decided in advance, the sampling is known as multiple sampling. I think these points are clear to all of you. I again repeat, in the case of single sample, sampling is known as single sampling. In the case of two samples, sample is known as double sampling. And in the case where a decision is made on basis of more than two samples and the number of sample is already fixed in advance, so this is known as multiple sampling. So there are basically three types of sequential sampling. Now coming to the next points of sequential sampling, what is that? When the number of sample is more than two, but it is neither certain nor decided in advance, then this type of system is often referred to as sequential sampling. What is sequential sampling? Sequential sampling is sequence or series of numbers. So basically, we can classify the data or sampling on the basis of numbers. When we use single sample, it is single sampling. When we use two samples, it is known as double sampling or two sampling. When the numbers are fixed in advance, sample are fixed in advance and it is based on more than two samples, then it is known as multiple sampling. But when the number of samples is more than two, but it is neither certain nor decided in advance, then this type of sampling is referred to as sequential sampling. Thus, in brief, we can say that in sequential sampling, one can go on taking samples one after another as long as one desires to do so. So there are maybe n number of sequences which are not fixed in advance. In the case of sequential sampling. So I think this is clear to all of you. Again, summarize all the points so that you can easily understand about the sequential sampling. So what is sequential sampling? It is basically a type of complex sampling design. So it includes few features of random sampling, a few features of non-random sampling. The size of sample under this technique is not fixed in advance, but is determined according to mathematical decision rules on the basis of information collected as service progresses. So basically it is based on collection of data or survey of data collection. This is usually adopted in the case of a statistical quality control. So it is basically generally used in manufacturing units for quality control of products. So what are the different types of sampling? If the sample is one, then it is known as single sampling. When we take two samples, then it is known as double sampling. And there, if there are more than two samples, but number of sample is fixed and decided in advance, the sampling is known as multiple sampling. But in the case of sequential sampling, sampling is based on more than two samples, but it is not decided or fixed in advance, then this type of sampling is known as sequential sampling. So in the case of sequential sampling, there may be n number of sequences. One by one, it can be increased or decreased according to data collection or survey, and it is not fixed in advance. So these are the features of sequential sampling. I think you can easily understand about this sampling, sequential sampling. If you have any query about this topic or any other topic related to research methodology, or you want to know about any other topic related to management also, you can ask me through comment box. If you like my video, please like and share this video and subscribe my channel Learning with Dr. Shivangi. We meet in the next video with next topic. Thank you everyone.